So in this example, we'll be looking at a differential reactor where we're trying to find the reaction orders alpha and beta and the reaction constant K for this gas phase reaction of A plus B goes to C plus D, where we know that the initial volumetric flow rate is 200 liters per minute, the weight of catalyst in the reactor is 5 grams, and the reaction temperature is 300 degrees Celsius. And we're also given this chart of data here at the bottom with several different runs where either the partial pressure of A was held constant while B was varied, or B was held constant while A was varied. And for each of these different runs, the concentration of the product C was recorded. So now that we can use these results to help us find alpha and beta and K. So our first step is going to be to assume a reaction rate law that'll help us figure out what these factors are. So we can assume that the rate of appearance of C, the reaction rate can look something like the reaction constant K times the partial pressure of A to the alpha times the partial pressure of B to the beta, and I'm using partial pressures here because that's the data that we were given. And now we can look at a case specifically to find alpha, where the partial pressures of B were being held constant. When the partial pressure of B is being held constant, then the partial pressure of B to the beta in this reaction order up here is also going to be constant. So then we can pull a little trick and lump it into the reaction constant K and define a new constant K prime, which is going to be equal to K times the partial pressure of B to the beta. So now our rate of appearance of C is going to be equal to K prime times the partial pressure of A to the alpha when the partial pressure of B is being held constant. So now we can take the natural log of both sides of this expression, and we end up with an expression like this that looks a lot like y is equal to b plus mx. And now we can plot the natural log of the reaction rate of C versus the natural log of the partial pressure of A in Excel and get a linear best fit line. And then the slope, or m, is going to be equal to our reaction order alpha. And then the intercept, or E, is going to be equal to the natural log of K prime. So to be able to plot these values, we need to figure out what the actual numerical values of the rate of appearance of C are. And for our differential reactor, we know that our design equation is the rate of appearance of C is equal to the molar flow rate of C over the amount of catalyst that's in the reactor. And from previous chapters, we also know that this molar flow rate of C is also equal to the volumetric flow rate times the concentration of C. And now we know all of these values. We were given the initial volumetric flow rate. The concentration of C was given for several different runs in the data chart. And we also know that the weight of catalyst in the reactor is 5 grams. So now I've come back to this reaction beta chart and used the differential reactor design equation to calculate the actual numerical values for the rate of appearance of C here on the very right column. And now we can take the natural log of these values and plot them versus the natural log of the varying partial pressure of A to help us figure out what alpha and K are. So now if we plot these values in Excel, the natural log of the rate of appearance of C versus the natural log of the partial pressure of A, and use the linear best fit line, then you can get an equation that's y is equal to 1.9x plus 1.6. So the slope here is 1.9, so then we know that alpha is also equal to 1.9, and the intercept is equal to 1.6, which was the natural log of K prime, so then K prime is going to be equal to the exponential of 1.6, which is going to be 5. So now our fourth step is going to be to find beta. So now we can use the data where the partial pressure of A is being held constant while B is being varied. So now, if we remember, our reaction order, our rate law that we defined was K times the partial pressure of A times the partial pressure of B to the beta, and now the partial pressure of A is going to be constant, so we can lump that into a new constant, K double prime times the partial pressure of B to the beta, and now we can also take the natural log of both sides of this equation to get something very similar to what we had before. So now if we plot the natural log of the rate of appearance of C versus the natural log of the partial pressure of B while it's varying back from the chart, then our slope is going to be equal to beta. So if we plot that in Excel and get a linear best fit line, we'll get that Y is equal to 2.1x plus 2.5. So now we know that beta is equal to 2.1. So now our fifth step is going to be to calculate what the real K value is. So if we remember back from whenever we were finding alpha, K prime was equal to 5, and then that was also defined as the real reaction constant K times the partial pressure of B when it was being held constant at 1 to the order beta. So now if we rearrange and solve for K, then that's going to be equal to K prime over the partial pressure of B to the beta, which is 5 over 1 to the 2.1 that we just found. So the reaction rate constant is also going to be equal to 5. So now that we know all these factors, we can rewrite the rate law instead of K as partial pressure of A to the alpha and the partial pressure of B to the beta, now as 5 times the partial pressure of A to the 1.9 and the partial pressure of B to the 2.1.